choreographer.
If Kelly's out there, I need a Bud Light, please. How many people in this room heard this band, let's say, 20 years ago? Sorry, how I moved to Key West, or how I ended up in Key West. I don't know about yours, but everybody I meet down here when I'm here, which is most of the time these days, I always say, what brought you to Key West? Why are you in Key West? I just had a conversation 10 minutes ago, almost about that same time. And almost every time, a story. Well, there's always a story, but every time there's always a good story. Well, I did this and I did that and I did this, and that's why I ended up here. I met a girl, I lost my job, or I'm running from the law, or you can't sell pot in Minnesota anymore, or the bales are out there, you gotta find them if you look. I never back it up. Mine was similar. Mine was that I got divorced and I wanted to get the hell out of Richmond, Virginia at all costs. And I'd come down to Key West a number of times before, actually a couple of times just hanging out, and came down and played back at Sloppy Joe's about around 1980, I guess. And back in those days, Sloppy Joe's was actually a local bar. It's hard to believe, but it was. And it was kind of a road R&B bar, too. You remember them days. You remember them days.
Yep, it's true.
It's true. So, and I met a girl. There's always a girl involved in there somewhere with me. And so I rode back to Richmond, Virginia with my band, and I said, band, I'm going to move down to Key West. And I said, Bill, you can't go to Key West. It'll chew you up and it'll spit you out, because you're in a very tender situation right now, being recently divorced and all heartbroken and all. And I said, well, that's one reason I want to get down here. It's the end of the road, and that's where I want to be. So I packed up my stuff, said goodbye to my boys over in Richmond, started heading down to Key West. So about North Carolina, South Carolina border, where south of the border is, if you ever seen that place, Pedro, south of the border. I decided I wanted a taco.
Don't eat the taco.
I knew a guy that was so cheap, he wouldn't take his family to Mexico, so he took him a weekend at south of the border. People that don't know about that, they're probably going, what the hell is he talking about?
I think it's still there.
Believe it or not, my mother used to work south of the border when she was a kid. Orange juice trees. And so I headed on down. I kept on going. I was plagued by indecision. I mean, plagued by indecision. I'm going, holy crap. What am I doing? But I didn't have no choice. I had to go far away, and this was the farthest way I could go. It's the furthest my car would make it. And I already had a gig set up anyway, so it worked out perfect. So by the time I get to 7 Mile Bridge, I pull out a doobie. Back in those days I smoked pot, I don't do that no more, but I did in those days. And I went in this dream, and in my dream, I'm driving along and I'm still plagued with indecision, and I almost turned around and walked away, turned around and went back, and this dolphin came up on the side of me. On this side, he said, Bill, he said, get your ass back to Richmond. He said, you got no business, no business, no business whatsoever of going down to Key West, Florida. You drink too much, you hang around too much, you carouse too much. You end up in the gutter. And this other dog came out on the other side and said, Bill, don't listen to that redneck, he's from Big Pine. Hey, watch out, boy, watch out. He has bad teeth and everything. You ever seen a dolphin with bad teeth? I never have, but that did that day. He said, don't listen to that guy. He said, you're going to do great down in Key West. You're going to go down to Key West, you're going to prosper. You're going to get married three times and lose two houses, but you're still going to prosper. And I went, well, that doesn't sound like prospering to me. He said, no, it's going to be okay. You're going to see. And I said, why is that? He said, because I'm going to give you a song, and you're going to sing this song all over the world. You're going to sing this song in Russia. You're going to sing this song all over the Baltics and Sweden, Norway, Denmark, and Finland, and in Ireland and Scotland, and all over Central Europe. I can't even remember. I've been so many times.
Estonia.
Estonia, too. Lithuania.
Anything with an Indian.
All over. Anyway, but I said, really? And she said, yeah. I mean, this daughter said, yeah. And it's gonna make you prosper, and you're going to do well. I said, well, if you say so, seeing as I'm stoned as hell and I'm driving across the bridge talking to a dolphin, I said, I guess I'm going to have to believe you. And he said, I said, well, what's this song all about? And he said, I'm going to give it to you right now. And this is what he did. A pretty girl, Cadillac, that's mine. Working down, working down, working down, though. sunny day. Say it's sunny. My good friend Courtney used to say the Morbid Tallywhacker Choir.